Hello, ladies Flashy, and gentlemen, right now. And welcome back to another BHL Live. Today, it's the Shenandoah Scorpions and the Steelers playing tonight for the Whalers' second last game of the season, and the Scorch trying to get into a playoff spot that has all, and those hopes have been all but squashed by the Hollywood Hattrick. Brandon versus Jets in the center faceoff circle. Pucks on the ice, we're underway. And now a breakaway for Brandon! Shooting off the post! And now into the far side corner. Centering was Brandon known there. Now Rojo getting a shot. Gets it to Brandon and that shot's off the post! The rebound hitting the iron as well. The puck comes all the way out. Here comes Jets through neutral territory. Jets getting it on net. The rebound came out, but Oil couldn't get a stick on it. The puck comes all the way back down. Brandon shooting. And another routine stop there for Zems. That shot off the pipe. And now Rojo playing it at center ice. Through center. And now Rojo's back in. Can't get past Oil. And here come the Oilers back the other way. Shoots just wide. Back towards center. And now here come the Scorched. Save there by Zem. No, that's Birdo. Back to center again. Jets trying to get another breakaway opportunity. He can't. Late hit there, no call. And the puck comes all the way back through. Jets getting on it. And Zems puts it out of the zone. They made a line change on the fly. Zems came on for Oil. And they continue. Jets facing Rojo. And now it's back in. Rojo with help from Brandon. Now it's into the corner. Brandon. And the puck gets centered. Chance there. Hit on Jets. And the puck gets cleared out. Here comes Zems. Through neutral territory. Lost the handle on it, and it's gonna come all the way back in. Brandon shooting, and that just went wide. And now Brandon trying to center it again, but the attempt doesn't work, and Oil brings it back to center. Puck entered back into the zone, and it's gonna come back across. Oil steering it around all of the Scorch, got it into the zone, but took, but hesitated a bit too long, and the puck comes all the way back out. Re-entry, though, works, and that's shot scores! Jets, first of the night! And now it's under review. We're going to take a look at this one for goaltender interference.
I'm not sure that I saw any goaltender interference.
I thought you said offsides.
Or was it offside?
If they're looking at it for offsides, I can guarantee you the play was onside.
Yes, I do believe that play was onside.
Yeah, I don't know, EB said it in chat.
Yep. And there you see it, the puck does not completely come out of the zone, so the goal will stand. Brandon and Jets play at center ice. Off the face-off, puck gets into the zone from Oilery. and he'll bring it all the way back. Oil off the post, and now Oil centering for Jets. The shot weak, and it goes wide. Rojo playing behind the net, and that'll do it for the first period.
This goal horn is way too long.
They played it. The reason that it went over the actual gameplay was because they played it after review.
Understandable. I do want to mention one thing. Zems is Joe's.
Okay.
He legally changed his name.
Puck held in by Oil. And now puck comes back out of the zone. This. With Rojo. And they'll duel in the neutral zone.
And that puck actually contacted one of the scorched players who was on the bench. Should have been
Brandon.
Should have been blown dead. Because he was on the bench.
Now Oil out of the zone. Here comes Oil. But Rojo back to defend. Still the shot gone on net. But Tiger with a good save. And now a delayed penalty call coming up.
Now it's going to go to their goaltender. So they're going to have to...
As the scores touch up, we'll get the call.
So their goaltender is going to get a penalty here. I'm not entirely sure. They're going to give
that
it to the goalie.
Tiger gets the interference call.
And yeah, that one, the goalie is going to serve this.
Welcome to the BHL, where unlike the NHL, the goaltender does serve the penalty.
Or does he? Who's going to serve it? Oh, and now he might get one for abusing the official.
Just thought I'd also like to mention that I think we might have Patrick Starr in attendance tonight.
Yeah, special guest is out here tonight.
Did he hit it with his fist or with his stick?
Stick.
Then, you know, I don't think you're allowed to do that. If you can do it with your fist, I'm pretty sure. But
so, Brandon... No, it needs to be someone who's on the ice, right?
I think it's they choose someone to serve the penalty. It doesn't really matter. But who are they? They don't have anyone in the box. And they're gonna...
Zayas.
So serving the penalty is gonna be Zayas. Rojo to try to kill it. Off the face-off, Rojo wins it, and here he comes through center. Rojo, all alone, but getting back were Jets and Oil, and now they come in 2-on-none. Oil, shot blocked there by Rojo, and the puck is lifted back to center. Rojo on a breakaway.
Oh.
Saved there by Berto, and the rebound doesn't find the net, and now here they come back the other way. Jets... Turn it over,
right,
and that'll end the penalty. Zayas gonna bring it through neutral territory. Now he's on a break.
Oh.
Score! Zayas coming out of the box, and he finds the pass and scores on the breakaway.
Bad positioning plagued the Whalers on that one with the goaltender.
And I think you can also say that it was a little bit of... not reading the play and understanding that that one of the players had just gotten out of the box,
mm-hmm.
or at least was about to get out of the box, and that's something that you always gotta watch out for is players coming out of the box and joining the play, because that can happen. Zayas shot there, and Berto with another good stop. Now W5K gets it in.
One of the rare usernames having only three characters in it.
Keeping it along the boards. And now Zayas can't get it to the blue line. Kept in. Zayas to make a second attempt. Doesn't work, and so Rojo now doing the hard or the dirty work trying to get this puck out of the zone, and it's still not out.
Wow, that puck
good
deflected.
Defense by Jets, and now Jets gets a shot away, saved there by Tiger, and now break Zayas again, but he doesn't have the speed, and so the Whalers get back and make the play. Still in the zone, Jets hopping over it, and now continuing to play it along the near side boards. Zayas across, no one was there. Jets nearly cleared it, but it's kept alive, and that'll do it for the second period. So although it was kept alive, it died shortly after. And now we got a player going after one of the fans. I saw a W5K head up into the stands, going after Rams. No call that was made on that, but the puck comes back in for Shenandoah. Now it'll come all the way back to the blue line, kept in by Rojo, sent up into the corner to be played by Brandon. Brandon on the forecheck, pressured here by Zems. And now the puck comes back down. Oilerator clears the zone, but Rojo is going to just toss it right back in. And it's played along further by Rojo again. Still stuck in the corner. And now Oilerator clearing it all the way to the blue line, and now it's out. Delayed penalty gonna be coming up. Let's see who it's on. It's gonna be against the Whalers. And now as the Whalers touch up, we'll get the call. It's gonna be, let's see what it is. It'll be an interference call against Oilerator. Now Jet's going to be the one man on the ice, penalty killing for Hartford. And off the faceoff, puck comes all the way across. Rojo, and he'll actually put it straight into the Hartford bench. We'll get a stop of play. The Hartford Whalers acknowledging their future tonight. And now Brandon with an opportunity, and it got close, but the post said no. Still alive in the offensive zone, Brandon playing it behind the net, pressured from the defense by Jets, and now Jets going to play it further, and now he's going to try and get it out. Rojo there makes the play to keep it alive, and out of the box is Oil. No power play goals yet in this one.
And W5K still fighting with fans.
Surprised that the referees have not acknowledged or even given penalties.
Oh, and that's
and there's a hit. That's gonna be a hit from behind.
From
Oilerator, and this is gonna be another Shenandoah penalty.
But it might not be a power play if W5K keeps coming over and hitting the other team.
Now there's snowballs being thrown. And now W5 has just gone straight over to the opposing bench. Puck still in the offensive zone though for Hartford. An Oilerator trying to find Jets. Loose puck gathered up by Zayas. Here he comes through neutral. Zayas saved by Berto on the rebound. Knocked away. Back to neutral territory. And now Zayas in again. Shorthanded. Shot. Save again by Berto. And now it's back out. Here comes Oil. He's checked off. Oh! Not score! Jets!
Second of the game.
Second of the night for Jets. Center scored 23. And the Whalers are definitely feeling that those North Carolina vibes tonight. And now another of their members, Jam0828, has joined. I think he's actually a member of the Hornets, actually.
That would be right.
Now
hey, I think he's on the Royals.
Back in the offensive zone. Dot! And the cross crease didn't have a connection. Empty net. 20 seconds left. Kept alive in the offensive zone. Empty net, Shenandoah. Clock cleared out. Here comes Jets. And sent back in. Brandon. Across.
3 seconds left.
And now it's cleared out of the zone. Late hit there on Oil, and there's going to be a penalty call, even though there's 0 seconds remaining. And it's going to be a roughing call against Rojo. So that'll give a 30-second power play to the Hartford Whalers, even though they've already essentially won this hockey game. 0 minutes remaining in the third period, and this will clinch the Hollywood Hattricks to playoff spot. And that'll do it. That's a Carolina Hurricanes win! Tuning in to this matchup of the Shenandoah Scorched versus the Carolina Hurricanes. I've been DMP. Alongside me was Flashy and TJ for a little bit of it, but we've got one more in approximately 42 minutes, and that will be these Hartford Whalers taking on the Michigan Hornets for one final matchup on the season. But until then, I've been DMP. You've been watching BHL Hockey on YouTube. Thanks for watching. Take care.
Yep. Also, for my viewers, one thing I'd like to add is the Hollywood Hattricks have now clinched their fourth seed place in the postseason after the loss today of the Shenandoah Scorched.
Eat.
So congratulations to those hat tricks. And we'll see you in 40 minutes.